Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is DeLady, and we are back with another episode of Meilin Zoo. And this time we're going to create a habitat for an animal we've already seen during the beta, which is the hippo. And I absolutely love the hippo, but the only downside is you really need to give them a huge habitat. We built a habitat for them during my Let's Play franchise mode series in the beta, and I had so much fun, but I just didn't have any time to really create a beautiful habitat for them. So yeah, this is basically me like, oh, finally I can create a beautiful habitat for them, and I'm actually really proud of it. Still, the surroundings are completely unfinished because this is so much work. But the view of different areas, the guests have like different points where they are able to stand and see the hippos from all the sides, except for one side, because I really want to have a big habitat for a totally completely different animal, but I have no idea yet which one. But that's why we leave that side. It's for you guys on the right side if you see it from this angle. So yeah, there will be some kind of different animal on that side, but it's absolutely lovely to just go around this habitat and view the hippos from so many different sides. And in the end, I also ended up with making a indoor habitat because I want a shelter, and I don't really feel it's a lot of fun to just give them a shelter right in the middle of their habitat. So right in the corner of their habitat, there is a big round, because I just love the round shapes, but not with like a round roof like we have with the dome. So it's a flat roof, but it is round and a little bit less annoying shadows, because the middle section of that shelter is basically just dark, so no weird shadows and those kind of things. I love to make glassy roofs, but the shadows can be super annoying. So yeah, we still have room for a different animal inside of that indoor habitat. I'm not really sure yet. I might go for the pygmy hippo. I really love those guys too. They're super small and tiny little hippos, so it's absolutely adorable. But for now, we're going to create this beautiful hippo habitat. And it basically has two different underwater viewing galleries. This is the first one I've built, and I do have to say this is inspired by a hippo outpost, but I have no idea what zoo it is from, because someone just shared that picture in my Discord server. We have like an inspirational channel, so everyone is just posting all the pictures they have found, they found interesting, of zoos in that Discord chat, so we can use it as inspiration. And I use it as inspiration, but I only know that it's called a hippo outpost. So if anyone knows from what zoo this is inspired of, I think later during the video you will get the idea of what it is, but I only saw a drawing from the top. So it's only the layout of the water with the underwater viewing gallery. And on the left side of this big underwater viewing gallery, there will be some kind of big restaurant. Now, I have been thinking a lot about it, like, how do I want to do this? And I'm still not completely certain, so I will just wait with building that. But the idea is that the people will be able to sit and relax and eat their food and stuff, and then they will also be able to see the hippos in their water section, or maybe on their land area, just walking around, making a lot of noises, pooping a lot. Well, pooping a lot is not really tasty when you're eating, but hey, it's a zoo, all the animals poop anyways. But I thought that was a really nice addition, and I also saw something like that on the drawing. So yeah, I really like this idea, and as I said, I'm just really amazed with the look of it. Like, the water is so stunning in this game, together with the lighting. It looks absolutely gorgeous. So I really hope you guys like this too and can use it for some inspiration. And I do have to say, like, the habitat is huge, like really huge. And still, if I add, I think I have 4 hippos in there right now. And they are really happy with the land right now, but the water should have been a bit more. Well, actually, I have been watching them for a long time and they didn't really went into the water that often. So I was like, what are you complaining about? But it's still in green. So it's only like 200 cubic meters. They would like to have more as a water section. So in the end, I ended up with creating a little water section too in the shelter area, which I really like how that turned out too. But they didn't even use that water section at all, but they did. Right away, when I put down the bedding, they came inside and they were like chilling and laying there, so like having fun. And I don't know. I really hope they will be using the water sections a bit more in the future. Maybe they are working on the animations that they're not doing that often, because I didn't have any issues with that during the beta. They were in the water like a long time. They were just chilling underneath the water. So yeah, I have no idea if they changed anything with the animations or whatsoever. How do you guys experience that? Did you create a hippo habitat already? And did you notice they are using the water a lot, or that they are not really using the water section? I'm just really curious how your experience is with that. Maybe I'm just very unlucky and my hippos are just chilling in the sun and they don't really mind to go into the water. I have no idea. I'm just really curious how you guys are experiencing this. So yeah, basically this is the first underwater viewing gallery and I'm really happy with how it turned out. The only downside is that if you have raised path, you can't really hide away the curbs. So instead of keeping them inside, I just wanted to cover them a little bit more with a darker wooden, unpainted, they're cold, I think. So with a darker wooden poles, I really wanted to cover it a little bit so it doesn't really look like the curbs of the path itself too much. So I'd rather just hide them away. And obviously we have some educational signs and some speakers and those kind of things. But at first I didn't have any electricity or whatsoever. So I had to put down a water treatment and transformer and of course a staff room and a keeper's hut. So you see a gate right now at that round little viewing area section, but I replaced the gate to the complete other side of the habitat, so next to the underwater viewing gallery. And later on we will create a nice building for it to cover up all those facility buildings, because we don't want to see that. So yeah, here's me building the shelter area for the hippos, and I just really thought, okay, let's use my dome, because that one is also in the workshop. For those that don't know, that dome I just placed down, you can find it in the workshop to download and just use it in whatever way you want. And I just really wanted to use the same textures, or at least to keep it a little bit in the same range of the dome we already have, because I just really feel like the more you use the same types of pieces and those kind of things, then it feels a little bit more like one whole of the zoo. So yeah, I'm really happy with how it turned out. We still have to do a lot of other things. So this will basically be some kind of Africa area, because what we do with the giant panda and the red panda, that area is basically more of the Asian animals. And in this section starting from here, there will be more African animals, and I think that are the two continents we will be using during this zoo mostly. We might want to add one or two other animals, but I think mostly African and Asian animals. And I just want to have the animals a little bit in the same area of my zoo to, I don't know, just have them separated from each other, or at least the two continents a little bit. But yeah, I'm just really excited to see how our zoo is coming along. I'm so happy with how the game looks and how the game feels and how the animals behave. I'm just so excited for this game, even though this is not franchise mode, so I don't really enjoy it that much as the franchise mode. But other than that, I'm just really happy with just creating beautiful habitats for them. And I really hope you guys enjoy that too, and that you are also just really excited with everything you can do with the game and how stunning it looks. So I do have to say that I did cut out a lot of the rockman placing and trees placement. You see a little bit of it to get the idea, okay, she did place down some trees, so you're not completely in the dark. But I did cut out a lot of it because I can imagine it's starting to get pretty boring if you see a lot of rock and trees and shrubs placement, so I tried to balance it out a little bit more to give you guys more of an idea of the variation, what I'm doing. But actually this recording was, I think, 3.5 to 4 hours in total, so I really cut out a lot of stuff also with like the terrain forming and those kind of things. So yeah, I really hope you guys enjoy the look of this habitat, and in the end I will add some cinematic shots for you guys, so I really hope you guys enjoy. Please do make sure to leave a like at the video if you did, and subscribe of course if you already haven't, and I really hope to see you guys in the next one. Bye guys!